very quickly, I will go to Mazi, your former, because he has been, he is here, and he is waiting patiently. And I'm going to go to him right now, and I will hand over the microphone to him. And Biafrans, I will say, please sit back, and your servant is here. Mazi, good morning. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, Mazi, you know. Thank you very much for accepting my call this morning.
Thank you very much for holding. Thank you very, very much for holding. Please, I will say right now, the microphone is yours. Take it away from me. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much. But before I proceed, I'm a man of few words. But this morning, your morning, me here is evening. It might take longer than required. Please, I'm pleading. And if anybody have any question, I'm happy to answer. So, don't be shy about it. If you're using a Skype or whatever it be, or whatever people ask you a question, I'm happy to take that question and then be able to ask more people. But before that, this radio is the mouthpiece of the Biafran Resurrection. We must give thanks to Chukwuka Grandma, regardless of the situation we find ourselves in. I always say this, and I may not have enough time to explain it again, who we are and why we do what we do, and why we always bring Chukwuka Grandma with his English word, God. God, when we use the word that is not our own word, that's where we become confused. Please, don't get me wrong. I am original. I abandon everything. I want to return back to the original. So if I'm speaking, just know there is one thing I want you to understand in your head. Now this man is talking from original. He wants to return back to the original. Not the inferiority, not that if they were against him, may have that way with his case. Please, that's not me. I am original. Whatever I'm doing, my first question is, how does my forefather do it? And if they tell me exactly how they did it, you know my answer? That is the way I want to do it. Not of today. So that is who I am. And that has a lot to say. But before I continue, from my own side, today is a beautiful day. And it's a day that people who can't ever met that we should all rejoice. And in our own calendar, Nepal calendar, it's Afor. For me, it's Afor, Afor, Tarani, Hama. And before I continue, I live so many years in it. I know a lot of things about this. I wouldn't say I know everything. I know a lot. I lived here for many, 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 many years. I still have a lot of friends there. I still have a lot of family friends there. And I do go and visit them whenever I have a time. So Israel is not a stranger to me. So, and today is a Shabbat, and we say Shabbat Shalom. But before we start, my own is evening, for many of you, say a morning or afternoon. It doesn't matter where you join us from. The earth is one. The creator is one. The world is before anything was created, the whole world was covered by the water. And we inhabitants are 10% of the planet. The rest is covered by the water. So without any hesitation, as our leader, you know, when I say our leader, many of you do not know who he is. Many of you see him as a brother. Some see him as a cousin. Some see him as the common man. Some even don't have any regard to him. He says, flesh like I am. You may be correct on that, because all of us are flesh. I mean, flesh. Flesh, you say, your flesh, you can pinch your skin, and it hurts. So the same thing. But all of us have things that are behind us. When you go beyond the flesh, you start seeing things. Some are demons, some are pig, some are dog, some are human beings. Some all manners of things you can even imagine in your life. I'm telling you the fact. That is the way it is. And some are the light. But before I comment this evening, it's a privilege and honor to speak on Radio Biafra. You know the reason. Many of you do not understand or do not know the reason. When I was a student of the Radio Biafra, because today I'm no longer a student, I had my 4th degree, even Professor Isnaya on the Radio Biafra. It's not another school. It took years to graduate, 1st degree, 2nd degree. Why? Because there's in Israel, they have a very wonderful institution. It's a science institution. For you to get into this institution, you must have a very high score. And you must have your second degree for you to get into this institution. If I'm not mistaken, it's called a wise man institution. It's in if I remember, it's the Ashdod or Ashkelon. I can't remember where is it, but don't get me wrong. I'm just drawing a reference to that. So for you to be able to get admission there, you must have your second degree. You must have high score. Because the level of your understanding must be higher above to certain level for you to be in that frequency of what is happening. There are a lot to say. I'm sorry, Mazi, I hope I will not take the whole of your program today.
Mazi, please go ahead.
Because everyone of us, I will have to explain to our people. Because there is a lot going on. Now, a lot we are confused, or is confused. And then we are the agent of darkness, and we have the part two of the daughters of Jezebel that can come to the bid of the devil to make sure they continue to hold the children of Ipob captive into perpetual slavery. But before I commence, we are sitting on Radio Biafra, which is the mouthpiece of Ipob captive. But before I do anything, I want to give thanks to him. Because he is the creator of the universe. He is the creator of our land. He owns everything that belongs in our land. It doesn't matter whoever you call. That is why all of us are suffering in this miserable situation. Because you abandon your own. And your own abandon you. There is no sentiment in this. And this is 100% mathematically correct. You abandon your own and your own abandon yours. That is in our adage. It's only those who understand that language who are able to understand that. You abandon your own and your own abandon you. So do not blame anybody. You blame yourself. That is mathematically correct. But we call upon the name of Chukwuka, but Chukwuka, you have to pardon me. I need to speak in the language of the Asian. When you call our creator, Chukwuka Diama, you're only listening to the language of the Asian. Our land is the epicenter of the universe. The life started in our land. The Garden of Eden started in our land. Our land is at the zero latitude and the zero longitude. Nyaka Ijaja, Nyaka, that's why we answer Ndebo in Asian during the time of the Pharaoh. They do come down to our land. Our people, we are a lot of them, we are dwarfs. We have heard the story of him, but dwarfs. We are the people of the spirit. Our duty every day is to pray to Kajama like the Levites in the Bible. So if you do not understand it, and I'm privileged and it's an honor to return back to that original. And I'm here to share some something to us and what is happening in our struggle so that we can be able to focus. We can be able to carry on like an empire in Bible. One hand with the sword, one hand with the rebuilding the Jerusalem. But before I do that, you have to pardon me for those who do not understand the English language. Our God we worship. You're not listening to him. He doesn't understand any other language. He only speaks in our language. If you remember, our leader always said, the language of the heaven. It's no mistake. Our leader is that Messiah. When he spoke this many years ago, 2012, 2013, I was curious. I went into research. Maybe I didn't take it. I went, I'm telling you, everyone of you, go back, go and do that to yourself. It's only you can do that research and come out. I went there, I thought I was just a joke. But I was marvelous what I found out at the end. Even our former candidates, what is and every one of them meant. You know, we are special. We are those wise men from the East. You remember when Yehoshua, they renamed him and gave it the name, the three wise men, they step out from the East. To quote everyone, said the wise men from the East. Well, look at mentioned that word. In this mess we are in, we are the people that put ourselves in this mess. But before that, I've said that a couple of my Brembo, but I have to call in the name of Chukwu Kadiama to be with us this evening. Open our ears so we can understand. We can listen and understand what his word meant. And then we can make sense out of it and deviate from people who are deceiving us. If you permit me, the presenter, I will speak in the language of the nation. We are children, I am a little bit of a I am a little bit of a And I'm as you call the only if you know how I've been when they and I yes, as you call a boss in game. But I need quite what Macanda would want about your gissing. I'm not going to go to the city of Tayana. Not I know about me when I could work for no to follow when I see yes, it's a book. What's your head, DJ Fenner? Why you end the book?
Sorry, it took me a while because I'll be speaking the language of fashion. Many of you that study our language, I'll study who we are. during his left reign, when our people, I will give our people a tip. You know, when you say praise and sing in the go to church, you say sing that praise. I'm sorry. I'm saying it in a different way. You may be right for a reason, but I'm saying it in a different way. The reason I'm saying that is sing and praises. Because you are singing and you are praising and you are happy. You are excited. Then what happened? You forgot that you are a spirit. You are not a human being. You are just a spirit, a being. But indeed, outside your skin, outside your spirit, you are telling your spirit everything is fine. Thank you, don't you? Isn't it? Now, I will tell you something. During the time of a slave trade, when our people are lifted, I have a friend who lived in Switzerland many years back. He told me his story. And the other day, a friend of mine again called me and told me his story. So I thought it was not true. And now I believe it's true. But I thought that it's not spread like hellfire. But I came to realize that all of them know who we are. Do you know the reason? I will tell you this evening the reason why the world is not we are rescued. If you like, you listen to it. If you like, you become your own self enemy. This is the point. This is the cardinal point. The secret is being revealed to people. But it's only those who are willing to listen to it. Now, what happened is, during the time of a slave, when our people will be selling, when our people were sold into slavery, when their master might treat them, they call their God. It's not what we are calling today. You remember those days he said in the Bible, he said, you will worship the God your ancestors have never worshipped. Yeah, you worship the God your ancestors have not worshipped. So, forget about it. Yeah, forget about if you are born into Christianity, if you are born into Islam. My question everybody I came across is, what was the religion? What was your forefathers worshipping before any of this? That's what I'm interested in. That's why I put it. That's what I'm interested in. Not of today. So, what happened is, when they maltreated, when they did something that they are not happy about, they will cry and call God. And then call upon him, and then we go and deal with the master. He killed them a lot of things. So when they realized they produced a padlock and something to make them cover their mouth so they would not speak. And they told this to their children. They said to their children, these people never die. You know, if people believe you die, that's it. There is a heaven and there is a hell. Nothing like that. This earth you are in is the hell. Yes. They said to them, they taught their people, these people never die. They reincarnate. We reincarnate. That is a recycle. You recycle. The flesh gets weak. You die off. You come back. Continue again. That is the fact. If you want to know, that's up to you. They taught this to their children to know about you. So this is one of the reasons when you go and start screaming, crying to the United Nations, crying to America, crying to Britain, crying to all the whole world, all the powers of the earth, they will not listen to you because they know who you are. Now, do you understand the reason? They will not come to your rescue. You are the people who will rescue yourself. Nobody will rescue you. So until we come to that level of the consciousness, we get to someone who is crying. Then we will be able to reach that level. Nobody we rescue you. They know who you represent. They know what you stand for. Then why do you expect the enemy to come and rescue you? Are you crazy? Are you mental? Are you demented? What language do I need to describe it to you? That you do not belong. You do not belong. It doesn't matter what you do. We have changed our name. We bear our manners of name. Still, they rejected you. They told you have no history. Maybe today, some of you just understand that we are zero latitude, zero longitude, which means we are the epic center of the earth. The crime started in our land. Civilization started in our land. So which makes it that the Garden of Eden started in our land. Adam and Eve exist from our land before anything else. I am making sense. I know I do not, because some people do not understand nothing. All they understand is a gossip. Money this, money that. That's what I meant. They say civilization started from Africa. So I will leave the rest to you to add up. We move on. Some people say they love Martin. He's their idol. They worship him. They will kiss his feet. They even lick his feet. They even lick where he stepped into. But still, the same people will not obey his command. There is something I want to tell you about Mazi Nnamdi, for those of you who do not understand. You know what we read in the Bible? Those of us that were brought up in a Christianity, I was one of them. I question at some point, I question my belief. Those days I used to live in Israel. I was there for almost 9 years plus. I question things. I question it. Because I see what is going on. But thanks to Radio Biafra, I graduated. And I'm above a professor. I will use that word. Because there are some questions you have to ask, and you can see the answer by yourself. And the spirit reveals the answer to you as well. Then you add the numbers together and come up. So that is why the words in the Bible, I am only interested in what is in the Old Testament. Old Testament is about us. I didn't mix word. The Old Testament is about us. Now we continue. We say we love our Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. He's our idol. But there is one thing we have forgotten. Now this fight is not yet over. This fight, if you go to a revolution, we won. But we have to actually fight for it. That actually brings to the point that the reason why many of us are where we are today, in the position we are in today. When all these things were happening, Chukwu Okeadwema said, I have raised many people to fight this cause. I have raised many, including the Wazirike, bishops, pastors, many, all of them failed woefully. Our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, is our savior. If you do not know it, if your eyes are still blind, they told us a Jesus Christ. His name is a Yehoshua, please. Name is very, very important to me, please. If you are talking to me, please give the right name. Because if you are giving the wrong name, you will not connect with me. I will brush you off. Jesus Christ is
is a European god. We are referring to him. When you say Yehoshua, Hashem, you are referring to the Israelites. It's two things. You say it doesn't, it's himself, you do not. Please, if you do not understand, call people to explain. I'm not putting confusion in anybody. Please, do not get me wrong. Nothing wrong about being a Christianity. You are free to belong to any society. You are free to belong to any social club. Do not misunderstand me. What I am saying is, I will repeat, I do not mix words. Name, the name you call someone, my name is Chukwudi. You start calling me Chukwemeka. I'm not Chukwemeka. You are calling, there are so many spirits. And when you read in the Bible, when they say, who shall we send? Send me, Father. The same thing as you are, as a human being. You are a spirit. You belong to, you went back to the niche here. You belong to your clan. Clan. It doesn't matter. The skin means nothing. When the skin dies off, the spirit return back to where you originated from. From where that you originated from, who shall we send? And those that in line will descend. And then we come to experience the living skin. So we need to go beyond all these things to understand who we are, what is actually happening, and understand the spiritual things of the earth. Instead of us being naive and blindly following things we do not understand. I may blame English language, but at some point in time, I do not, because it required an interest. It's only when you show interest, that is how you are going to know exactly what is happening. Like Mazo below said, where the feast of a tabernacle. It's all about us. I didn't mix words. We have done our atonement. He said he will scatter us. Strangers will take our vineyards. Everything in our vineyard will be taken by the strangers, those that we do not know. And we shall be worshipping a foreign god that our forefather never even knew about, not even talk about of it, or not even dream of it. Today, is you know what we are doing? And I'm not accepting, I'm going to tell you exactly. And those of us that jump into ordinary, see this ordinary, this, that ordinary, you are swear getting it wrong. There are the good ones and there are the bad ones. In our land, I will tell you exactly from the beginning. If you want to hear, if you do not want to hear, that's your own cup of tea. From the beginning, the Genesis, in our land, we only have two spirit gods in our land, and we name them Harachuku in the north, Agupumri in the south. These are the two spirits that can be people, the Afro people, with that part of the earth. We say, if only we know what we have. If you cross, you know, people say that the Ipob is an idol. That is crap. I say crap. More and more, more and more, it should be the Ipob. What we do not understand is, these gods, they bear different names. But we are connected. Ibias local name. So if your dialect is Ibibio, you call him in your dialect. If your language is Ibo, you call him in your Ibo language. he's the same. Only if we know who we are, but the white people know who we are, and they continue to put us in that slavery until we rise up. How do we rise up? We rise up to jettison everything. Before they came, we know who we are. If you do not know, there is a book of Epuano. Epuano. He left so the England, he regained his freedom. He taught us everything, what they brought in there. We already want in all this. Now we remind everyone to that. And now we move to the next one. The next one is last night we had our HOD announced sit at 12 in October 1st. These are the things we have to observe if we want freedom. Freedom is not cheap. Freedom is that you give us something little to get something greater. Those that I'm sorry to say this, I'm not saying it out of pride. I'm humble and sorry to say it. Those that we die. It's already marked. That is why you need to know who is that chief. Chief is your guide angel. If I explain this to people, when they say in the Catholic Church, they said, oh, guide an angel, Angel Michael, pray for me, Angel Gabriel, pray for me. I'm sorry, I'm not demoralizing those of Christian or Catholic or anything else. Denomination is different. I have to explain it so we can understand it. I have nothing wrong with you. I'm actually a Catholic. I'm actually a part of the parish priest. Until 2016, I resigned. So do not get me wrong. So when I'm saying it for people to go and then discover by themselves. Anything religion is a social club, I'll emphasize. I'm not criticizing one or the other, but I'm just pointing this out because you have to belong to where your people are. That is my point this evening. I didn't come this evening to say demoralize or point, but one thing we know here is example. Australia, where I belong to, I'm a citizen of here. I don't have any dual nationality. I'm an Australian. Anything Australia is doing, let me say this to you guys, you do not understand. They acknowledge the gods of the land, all the way from the junior to the top. If they are sending you a letter or email, you see it at their bottom. They said, we acknowledge the traditional owners of the land. Present and the past. We respect them. But if there is a ceremony that welcoming a foreign guest, they will perform a fire, they will call indigenous people, and they will explain, it says to welcome the good spirit, draw the bad spirits, but in your own people, they will say it's the evil. That one did be an accord, is bringing something else, is demoralizing. But others, they will just acknowledge that because every land, understand this, every land, we say it in others anyway, but anyway, every land, there is a God that owns that land. So anything they talk to you of all this, I wouldn't say all these things that is confusing you. You need to know yours, and you follow yours. Only then we have a salvation. That's all I want to say. But then I will continue. October 1st, we say we want Biafra. We say we are yearning for Biafra. And we will die for Biafra. And many of us have died. Many of our comrades has died. And I swear, I'm not better than of them.
I stand where they stand, and I'm with them, and we are not going to leave them behind. Our word is our bond. We are not going to allow any Zulu flag in our land. We have to reject them in every means, every possible. We are not violent, but we are going to use the civilization, civil disobedience, to reject every atom of anything they bring into us. We must say no, we reject you. It doesn't matter where it's coming from. It doesn't matter who is pushing it from. It doesn't matter who is conniving with them. We must reject it. And then, that brings me to tell people what is going on gossiping. You know, as we say in Biafra, we have a lot of people who gossip. You know, market women, slandering. I remember some people even here, when our leader came here, people started to still gossiping. I don't know if it's the poverty of the money. I am not rich. I wouldn't class myself as rich. But I'm content with what I have. But some people find it interesting. Why anything to do with fire or money? You see them jumping up and down as if they haven't seen dollar or euro in their life before. I do not understand. I'm not going to dwell on this evening because I just lost words to describe some of us. I do not know because this earth is coming. You are a nation. If you do not connect from your previous life, which is your chief, Tawadena, Chinese does it very well, Japanese does it well. It's only we that are just discerning our own. If you do not connect back where you return, if you do not connect back to continue your journey, then you become a lost person. But it's for you to go and find out. It's not the topic of today, but Japanese does it. So, I'm not sure why our program is all about money. But all I have to say is it has to do with the civil war. You know, we die from starvation, reincarnation. When you invite them without food, they will not come. When you cook food, they will jump in. We see everybody. It's part of the spirit. That's what we say. That's right what we describe. They are very poor all the way to the spirit, so they cannot afford their food, which is a shame anyway, and it's disgusting. We must get October 1st, we must it at home. Anyway, we have a Biafra France school, name it, let the banks take the food back down by themselves. We give them that respect. I thank you very much for announcing that. We must jettison everything off about Nigeria. Now, the next thing I have to touch is about this. We have seen a lot of people making videos here and there talking nonsense about IPOB doors here and there, that and that. I want to refer us back to the beginning. Couple of months back when our leader was arrested, we came to this radio. We announced there are people that in Nigeria, the Zulu government paid money to destabilize IPOB from inside. We came to this air on this holy platform and announced it. And today, what is happening? We are seeing it. We will see people from here and here. And those who say they love Mazi and Kanu, they do not love him. What is happening is, I will tell you, Biafrans, pay very close attention.
This is how you detect them. This is how you find them out. It's a very simple trick. They said they love Mazi and Nnamdi, isn't it? I myself that love Mazi and Nnamdi, I do not sing it like a subject. Because what I will do for that man is in my heart. But let's say those that say that they speak out loud, because everybody is different. Some people are spoken. Some people are quiet. I'm one of those that are very quiet. So my men, I don't make noise. None of people with me. I don't need their popularity. I don't need people knowing me. I don't need anybody's friendship. I don't need anybody to know me. I don't need anybody to come close to me. I don't need to come close to anybody. That is who I am. So, they said they love him. They cherish him. They admire him. They will hang themselves in the world. They will hang themselves in the pole because of this man that came to serve his king. He's a prince, of course. He's born with a silver spoon. He attended a defining school, money can buy. But he did exactly what Moses did. And said, I want to align with my people. I've known that man since 2012. 9 years. Material things doesn't move. In his heart is the interest of our people. That is paramount to him. I remember every time we want to do something, it's going to cost money. He told me, myself, how can we do it to be free? We want our people to have it free. Suffering is heavy. And it's one of the reasons he didn't want us to have every Monday sit out. Because you look at it and said, oh, the burden on the average person, I don't want them to have that burden for me. Let them go out and have their business. If a chukwu kaze, sorry, I don't say Elohim. Elohim is an Hebrew word, and Elohim is El Shaddai. If a chukwu kaze, because in every language has its name, so I prefer to call him in my own dialect. I learned this, when you argue with, when I acknowledge those days, I was a fool. I acknowledge that. I can't remember the guy. If I see him today, I will say, thank you very much. He said, why don't you call him in your own language? I said, it doesn't matter. You can't say the language. But as year progress by, you understand it, people mean something. I'll say, you call him in your own language. But that's why I call him in my language. So our leader means, one of us. He's a very kind man. And I was one of the first people to call him a prophet. He's. Now you have a show you are looking for. That is him. If you do not know. He said that will be the last miracle. And they tell us what is going to happen. That is him, if you do not know. Everything that is going to happen, he knew about. Before he was picked up, he was in our last meeting. He said to us, even if I'm not around, we must. As a flesh, he might have a benefit or that, but the scripture must be fulfilled. Now this brings me to those points of course they have rock in my IPOB is a structure that our leader built based on commander. If you ask me what is the meaning of commander control, I will say to you, if you you obey your line manager from excellence. In every factory, every office, you obey the line. I mean, any issue, point we are fine. That is what I understand. But when our leader was arrested, I want everyone to pay authentic to this thing. I want to say, I'm not saying this to break anybody or to make anyone. But what I'm saying is the fact that I have taken my time to look into. And if you call me tomorrow, ask me the same thing, I will say exactly the way. And that, Madam Nnennaya, she did not withhold any recent money. I repeat, Madam Nnennaya, not withhold any recent money. I will go back to the beginning of the Genesis for those who do not understand how we started from Goriji to where we are today. When the Radio Biafra was started, that was in, if I'm not mistaken, in April or May 26th of April. That was when people was buried on the 11th of April. 11th of February 2011. And then Radio Biafra started floating in April 2011. And then there are so many of them, I can remember them, Mazi for us, Ipa, Mwana Marachi, and a couple of them, and then so on and so forth, on a short way. After a few months, I had a contact with them, and then that time, everything goes forward. Because what happened was, when our leader remember God, and God said, as we remember in the Bible, my servant Moses have gone. I want you to lead my children to the promised land. And our leader took the lead. He told us how he was in the church. He was an Anglican. He was in the church. He summoned that day, reflected for Noah, running away, Jonah, exiled. The same thing I can explain how he was brought back to the zoo. He escaped from killing him. Jonah swallowed him, bring him back to the zoo to finish the assignment. So we as a people, we must rise up and support and follow what is going on. So back to what I was saying, I just draw these references for people who do not understand what is going on. Our leader put all these things in place. Some we do not know. Some we do know who they are. Many we do not know. As I was saying earlier on, Nnamdi do not, because I personally asked her, did you, Nnamdi, transfer money from US to German account? She says no. From European countries, she says no. Then I asked her, then what is the hell are they talking about? The answer is, Mazi, I do not understand it. Now, I do not understand. I will go further in detail. Because this question I asked it our HOD. He misunderstood to myself,
he was saying the same exactly what Nnamdi is saying, but I was finding it offensive. But what are you telling me? Are you telling me this never happened? So I was speaking like somebody is talking in their Latin language. That doesn't, a different language that doesn't exist. Because that is exactly what Mazi Kedezia was telling me, is what Nnamdi was telling me. I didn't understand what Mazi was actually telling me. A lot of those things happened. So I was saying, what are you saying? I don't understand. I don't understand what you're saying. So just forget that. I said, that's okay. I know what, yeah. I have to go. I didn't tell him I'm calling somebody else. I called him and I started seeing her. Now she's telling me exactly. I said, what is going on? And that is what is going on. You know, as I said, I'm not your former. One thing I'm not going to do is that everybody that knows me, I don't do anything evil of anybody. But the truth, I will speak. You don't need to be my friend. I don't need to be your friend. What holds us together is the truth. If you are colliding evil, do not even mention my name. So whereas I become very, very upset, I said, how did such a thing happen in my presence? I didn't even instantly apologize to Nnamdi. I said, my apologies to you, please, my sister. That was the first language that came out of my mouth. I'm saying it openly on the public. My apologies to you. I thought that you transfer money to from anywhere account. So she said no. She said, ask me any question and we answer me. I said no. My apologies. And I'm going to speak out. I'm not afraid of anything. Anything I want on this earth, I've already had it. I'm not missing anything. Anything, good life, cars, name it. What is the best car on this earth? I have it. Name it anything at all. I'm not the person you will use money to come and knock. I have them already. I'm the one that will give you. So I apologize. I said I have to make it right. You are voiceless. And I do understand it. Nobody's right. We do have our own shortfall. But what pains me mostly is sending the letter to our community with the ego of our time. I mean, the ego of our time. Town, accusing her of something she did nothing. That is what pains me mostly. And secondly, punishing her image in the social media. That is barbaric. That is uncalled for. That is on purpose. That is to destruct what we are doing. That is planned. And that is well organized. Now let's go back to how it was organized. I have a lot to say this evening. That's why I said myself, because you may have to permit me. I may go beyond of a Shabbat. I've talked about Shabbat and I need to say a lot of things. So to clear the air, if you need to record it and share it, to do that, I have my permission, but what I do know is I will say it where it is here. If I wake up, if somebody call me tomorrow, I will say exactly the same thing. I'm not mixing words. I don't need anybody friendship. I don't even a man will be like, I don't need you to call me. I don't need your friendship. So to start with. So we continue. So the truth is what I will tell everyone. And these days, truth is meaningless. Why do I say that? you go on the social media, people say true. But then you find out when you dive into that truth, they have already been bought over. But before that, let me finish with the accusation of Nnenna. Anybody that accused that woman, anybody, I repeat myself, anybody that accused that woman of withholding ESM money should go and apologize to her privately. When the IPB was started, I was the first person that approached Mazi and the current chairman and said, why don't we put a paper? People will donate. I was the first person that donated money to Radio Biafra. I was the first person that actually put relay station in Biafra land and followed by Nnamdi. Go back to the beginning of the history. So anybody that accused that woman, you want her apology. You go back and apologize to her. She did nothing wrong. What the enemy wants to do is, because if the enemy wants to bring you down, the person is your finance. They attack Nnamdi Anya to weaken her in every angle. Unfortunately for us, we do not know. I'm still apologizing to Nnamdi. Please forgive us. We do not know. Because the attack was coming, we still in a shock of our leader. It was now we actually understand what is going on. And please, from the bottom of your heart, accept this apology. We must move on. I wouldn't say this. Remember what you told me 2015 when our leader was first arrested? It's just a conversation between you and me. Remember what you told me. And I'm returning that favor back to you. 2015. We must not forget how we started, where we started. It doesn't matter what the enemy wants to do. We must make sure we uphold this. Because the enemy is at the center of what we are doing. They will come in a different manner. Like I said, our leader is not there for 2 weeks. They said, give us somebody that will speak to him. Give us somebody that talks to him like him. So we start following that person. That is your people. Please. Get to solve any anger you have in your heart and let's continue moving forward. If for the benefit of every one of us, our children will have a home where they call home. For me, I don't care. But for the children we born to have a place they call home. Now it takes me back to those next to my agenda. And that is those that are gossiping on social media. Because social media is meant for people to come and express themselves. There are so many people who are there just gossiping for not listening. There are those who are there just saying things that doesn't exist. There are those there who recruit people, giving them money, $1, $2, $100 every month, and all manners of things. Now, I will say this. I will use in the parable to explain some of these things. Please, if I do not understand them, please endure with me. But I will explain it the way you understand those that are behind all these things. Because I'm not good at calling people's name for the benefit of a doubt. You know, they're accusing them now of knowing where our leader is. You know, our leader was in Kenya. I will say most of all those things are false. Because the same people that are accusing Nnamdi of throwing our leaders in Kenya, they are the ones that actually send money to our leader in Kenya. Are you understanding me? In 2019, when our leader wants to come here, our leader told me, Nnamdi told me the airline I will not buy tickets for my leader. So Nnamdi knows where he will not buy tickets for our leader. And he must instruct him otherwise. That one is cleared. I repeat, I do not mix words. Those that are accusing Nnamdi knows that our leader is in Kenya. They are the actual people that send money to our leader in Kenya. Our leader was in the hospital. They sent my money to him. I saw the account published. They're actually the one that actually sent money to our leader in Kenya. And in the real fact, they're the one that knows our leader, where our leader is. So in essence, if we need to know what happened to our leader, we hold those people that are coming to the air, crying, going to different platforms, making an audio, talking about their doors, Nnennaya, that they know what happened to our leader, that the people we should hold responsible. Nearly and God. I didn't mix word. I repeat, I do not mix word. These people, Nnamdi, they transfer money to our leader in Kenya when he was in hospital. They know he was there. They are the ones that are working with the government. If you remember a couple of months back, we come here, we said to you guys, the zoo government released money to destabilize IPOB from within. And many people do not believe, many people believe. And that is what is playing out now. The good thing is, every year we have our atonement. Before the atonement and after atonement, things do happen. That is the what you are seeing now is our full effect of all those things. They know. If we should hold anybody responsible, they are the people we should hold responsible. They thought that they are too smart to turn it around and hold us, set up doors. And people doesn't have... I will come to the word of those that are talking and who criticizing us. I will come to that in the town. Because the cause I will let to those people, only to go gather when we lift them up. We lift it up. I'm coming. Let's just finish this. So, they are the ones actually conniving. And our leader trusts them. And sometimes if I go back to sleep, I just start blaming myself because all these things, all these issues that happened at those that joined IPOB during the COVID, that was last. Because our leader is trying to carry everybody along. And in the process, as a human, we make a mistake. But one thing that fascinated along them all is, on the 19th, he was arrested, June. He was telling us in the meeting, if you are not here, you must continue. See, he must have known what is going on, what is going to happen. But he's happy to follow the faith and make sure that the accomplishment of Biafra resolution is here. The question is, are you going to allow those that are gossiping? Now, those that are gossiping, we come to them. Because they don't deserve any room for us. We don't deserve any popularity. We put them where they belong. I do not know them. I've been in IPOB. I'm one of the oldest. I repeat. I am one of from the beginning. I will say, from the day the former radio Biafra start broadcasting, I've joined. Since then today, I'm one of the oldest. I never know how this people. I work with so many people. We have been our people at heart. But these people coming up, I will tell you what they are doing. What they are doing is, like Efe, our sister, Efe, I know when she joined the radio club, I called her actually to see if she can come and broadcast. I remember she was freaking out. Oh, how do you get my number? Why do you call me? Why is it me? I felt all those things, you know, there. Oh, I don't worthy of that. I said, no, you are worthy. Why don't you come? So, all those things, I can see, yeah, which I have nothing against. And she came out and apologized because we do everything to the best of our ability to help ourselves because we know what we are facing. What these people did is, I will explain this to you guys. Bring your pen and paper. Write it down. I will start. It might take a while. And then please forgive me if I mumble or if I dive to a different area.
I just try to connect all the dots together, please. What I did is, before our leader have a problem, they contacted a prophet called, what is it, I can't remember, if I remember, my own prophet. Yeah. One prophet, what is the name? The name will come later.
Mazi, is it a good prophet?
Yes, I had a good prophet. They contacted him. And then, you know, people are so gullible. They gave him money. And they gave him something. Oh, there is a people in the U.S. There is a lady in the U.S. There is this person they are going to betray. Because they already know where our leader is. I can tell you, if I knew our leader is in that place, I will advise him 100% of the time. I wouldn't hide my feelings. I lived so many years in Israel. When it comes to security, I know my level. I will advise him. But this blue nose does the thing. So, they push information to the group prophet because they are my agenda. And we have a reliable information. The zoo brought money to destabilize that POB from inside. Now, what happened? They are the people that actually send money to our leader to pay for his hospital bill in Kenya. They are the same people that come out and said, oh, our leader was arrested, he was killed, and he resurrected from the dead, and this and that, and all those things to apply to your emotion. Are you following me? That is why I do not have any heart. I must say this. My heart is as stone as rock as a stone. I'm not sure rock and stone, they are the same word. But I'm not sure the one that is much harder than the other. And then drive your emotion because you know every one of us love our leader. Now they said, they pick up with them and said, oh, you know this, that. In my heart, I have to be honest with you guys. I worked with Nnamdi for so many years. I know she will not, but as a human being, I just hold on to see what is plainer because since they do not judge just from one side. I just hold on to see actually what is plainer. And from what is playing out, they are actually the one that send our leader money to Kenya. And our comrade Mazi came on the air here and said that time when this thing was happening, Nili called and said, can you provide the leadership? And he says, I'm taking over. Our leader is there. And before the leaving here as well, people are saying that does is fighting for position. The reason I'm saying all this and putting all this point together is for everyone what is happening. In those we do not have any fight. We have a hatred with everybody's do what he does. We're even more united and organized than 2015. But because these people have taken that time to accomplish, sometimes it can complete their duty. Sometimes I wonder, I say to myself, if our leader is asking, where did you get from? There are people I will not even talk to or call them on the phone. They're already. Where did you get these people from? I will talk to Nnennaya. They made out all manners of accusation about this poor woman. Nobody is perfect. I'm not saying that my is perfect. Nnennaya, I'm saying it up in the air. I don't care if she attacks me tomorrow. Nnennaya can snub you. But that is personal. I'm not saying Naya, I'm telling you who she is. Nnennaya can snub you. I'm not taking it personal. I
And if you take it personally, fine and good. But I have to say the way it is. But if I don't have a good interaction with her, she may well be honest. That is her character. I'm not defending on that. But every other accusation they know, this woman cannot defend. We ask for it. They said that she reported the account of ESN with seven other people. We said, tell the bank to provide us the details, the reports, how they report the account. At this very moment, this woman cannot provide us. We said to them, if somebody cannot provide, then this woman cannot provide that. Up to this very moment, they cannot provide that. So which makes their point annoyed. Because they are accusing innocent. Now what they do is they approach you. If you do not agree, Chinasa said to them, they contacted and said, why don't you cover for a leader? I had this conversation, she was in a USA meeting, and she came out and Mazi Chinasa come on and say that. And then behold, what did this woman did? Is it today I wake up this morning and see a video she made on Chinasa, saying Chinasa took 2 million naira to kill a ESN and other things. Who is going to follow this crap? This is called a blackmailing. Simple blackmailing. Because what we are doing, our hands are clean. It's Chukwuoku Gadiama calling. When you come with evil intention, he's going to fail. He said, Chinasa, quick money, sir. We say it in Adesham and they are Gambali for me. I know who will come out and then and defend it and take an oath against. Everything that comes out of this woman, I call them daughters of Jezebel. When I came out below that spiritual broadcaster said that this woman, all the problem, American, 90% American, they are the daughters of Jezebel. They came to destroy the hard work of Mazi Nnamdi. Even to the platform they are using, those people are working with them. Understand this. They are working with them. They are collaborating with them. They are doing everything with them to demoralize what we are doing. Yes, I repeat. They are working. Any platform they go and speak, the people they are sharing anything they are talking about, they are the people that get money. And we go further deep in down. What these women did, explain it. If you do not listen to the girl, listen to what she said. It happened in our media as well. They get to certain people. They provide money to them. They recruit people for them. And they are giving them data, money, material things to buy them over. These people cannot speak. Because of Mgwene, she Abeli, they cannot speak. They cannot come out and speak because they've already been bought over. This woman gradually gave them money, buy them all over. They cannot speak. That is what is happening today in IPOB. We just see the day of the light. The answer is no. The only savior they have is to start speaking up. Now. Instantly now. Otherwise, Chukwuoku Gadiama on this radio that I'm speaking. If they do not speak up, after 7 days, if nothing happened, then I will start coming to this radio to talk. Because I know that then I will know that I'm not worthy to come to speak on this radio, Biafra. I'm not worthy. Everything I'm saying is false. And I will ban myself from coming to this radio. And something will happen to me, I will not be even coming to this radio. But if what I'm saying is true and what I'm saying is correct, there's something happening, they do not come out and start to tackle these people instantly. Then silence me forever. I don't want it to be on this earth anymore. That's my utmost. We have to call a spade a spade. So what if you say they spend money to find people over, they start talking rubbish. Now all of them has to come out. They have 7 days to come out and start speaking out and then revive everything they did. All the money they took, we have done our atonement. Unless if there is nothing like Biafra, then we know we go home and rest. We have no we have nothing. All we have is just the word to speak. Nobody did all these people with anything. But they're working with the enemy to make sure they keep their children down. Shall we allow them? I wake up this morning, saw somebody talking about China, sir, this, that, the same money. All these things are fallacy. False. Somebody that was expelled from IQB. She became upset. Obsessive because it's that I need to tie that, I need to bring you that, I need to do a manner of things. Are we kidding? And we are tied, including those that provide all this garbage. I'm not giving you another. I'm your humble servant. If I'm not worthy, if nothing happens, then it means that I'm not worthy to come to speak on this radio. Just take me away. So I will never ever come back to this radio to talk again. But if you want me to come and speak on this radio, may something happen to these people. Because we cannot take it anymore. They come to destroy all the work hard. Your children, they have poured their blood. But these people just, on the mission of destroying what you have built. On that I stand. What left of this earth? What do I get if I know all these things are nothing? We are people are not free. It means nothing to me. It's better I gone than be alive today. We must rise up anywhere we see all these people sharing all this information. We shall attack them. They are the agent of the darkness. They are the people that are colliding with these people. They are the people that are doing everything to make sure what we are doing never come to truth. They are the people that is using fake money. They are using their money to buy people over. Including people that are talking, say they are disciples of Mazi and Kanu. They go to their platform and using their platform to propagate all this false information and they are harboring them. And giving people data they cannot speak. They are talking the truth and say that it's false. May it be their torture. We have suffered. People have died. People have sacrificed everything they have in this struggle. We must take this serious. If you say you love Mazi and Kanu, follow the instruction of those. Those will never betray you. Those will never compromise. Rather, everyone will resign and go away. You want to do what Israel did when they couldn't see Iran. I mean, they couldn't see Iran. They went to Iran, more than the golden part. What if somebody that is able like Iran we can worship so we can have someone to communicate? You want someone to speak like a Mazi and Kanu. That's why you're going to that place. Bring somebody, come and talk to us. We need somebody speaking like him. Are you crazy? Something wrong with your friend. Are you okay at all? I ask. I don't think so. Because if you're okay, you wouldn't think that way. You would think for the radius of your leaders, the man you say you love so much. He instituted a judge. Every instruction comes from that. People are just demoralizing that because they are the people that were paid. I said today, from today, anybody is in cascading does know they are the people that were paid. They are the people that are on their payroll of that month. That's how you know who they are. What is the meaning of money? Do you think you can buy me with money? Do you think you can buy other people with money? What is money? Maybe you are poor. You haven't even had anything. I will feed you for your generation. I don't need your money. So when you talk about money, you know who you talk to. Not everybody money moves. Our leader money doesn't move by any inch. As a former, money do not move me an inch. Everything I need, everything I want on this planet Earth, I have it abundantly. I don't lack nothing. Understand it? So when you come with money, it means nothing. So look for people that you can use that thing to buy over. Not people like us, because it means nothing. I've already had them all. There is nothing new you can offer me or give me. That is the point I'm making. I'm not poor. Nothing. I said nothing. If I want to walk, I walk. If I don't want to, I do not walk. So there is nothing. So make it clear that your money has a limitation. So does our leader. It doesn't matter what your part been. So does many of us. So, dear friends, we need to get this on gossiping on the social media. They are here to destroy us. Anybody that is holding ESN fundraising, I swear in the name of Chukwukuka Adiama, Ekekere Ni Benada. Anybody that is holding the money of the people who contributed to help, to alleviate the poverty in our land, to help our people. Now in Chukwukuka Adiama, unless if you do not exist. Unless if there is nobody like you, you do not. Everything we are talking about you does not exist. Then, may they continue to see the day of the light. And may they continue to see the day of the light. If they continue to hold our money. But if you do exist, I'm putting this challenge you. I'm not the first person to do that. Abraham did it. And we're doing the same. You say you are piloting this affair. And you say you are the one in control. And you say our leader will come out. If there is nothing happened to these people, then it means that every Biafra, all your 10th Israel, everybody should go. Nothing is like you. But I stand on this radio. I'm putting this challenge. There is day like you. You will perform your wonders and crush all the enemies. Anywhere they are coming from. That is why they call it the North, East, and West and South. They call it the will be done. Those that standing unaware, may we just bulldoze at them. Give us your strength. We take them out of our way. Our path is straight. Biafra is our destination. Anybody that comes in between, may you take that person away. This is what I'm saying in this radio. And today is a Saturday. Overseer for on this radio Biafra Middle East. Mazi. Abida.
Yes, Mazi.
Thank you so much for giving me so long. Taking so much of our time. I think I've spent 1 hour 30 minutes repeating myself or repeating things, but I think I have to prepare way for others to speak. But I have to, sorry if it took me that long time to actually get it out. But yeah, this is it, what it's like. We need to tell ourselves the truth. We need to tell our people what is going on. We need to align ourselves with the truth. And that is what I have done this evening. Anybody that is listening to the Daughters of Jezebel Part 2, you are wasting your time. Those people have been expelled from IPOB. There is no element of the truth from what they're saying. All the concussion is evil. Mentioning Mazi Chinasa and other people, those things are false. Forged. Coming from the pit of hell. They have been expelled from IPOB. They have no truth in any of their words. Opportunity was provided to them to prove. Provide the evidence, they do not. Anything they are doing now is just a witch hunt to bring, looking for people that will drag them with themselves. Biafrans, I will say, we should rise up against all this nonsense. We debate any of the gossip. We should follow what Nehemiah did in the Bible. One hand with the sword, the other hand with the rebuilding in Jerusalem. We fight our enemy with one hand, and we continue to rebuild the Jerusalem. Biafra is restored in the truth and in honesty. Biafra is our hope, and nobody will stop us. I will stop here this evening. My evening is 7:17 p.m. Saturday, Shabbat evening. Thank you.
Mazi, thank you very much, Mazi. Before you hold on, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear.
Please hold on before you go. I would like to ask you to do something, and what I want you to do, I'm gonna read a scripture. It says here, that is, you know, this is one of our signature here on Radio Biafra Middle East, and I want you to do it before you go. And I think I have a question for you also, but let me read the scripture. It says, as you wish that others will do to you, do so to them also. So the reason why I read this portion was, I want you to pray for Israel. Yes, it's true that we want our freedom. We want God to do what we want. We want God to give us our freedom. We must also pray for other people. Like, as you know what is happening in this land of Israel.
Yes.
So that will be your parting shot. So what I want to ask you, what I want to ask you now is, I don't know if I'm to put it in question or I don't know how to bring it to you. To be honest with you,
put it in question.
All right. To be honest with you, I listen to every single thing you have said, and it is. I don't know how to put it, but I will go straight and say, now, you said something. You know, all of these things, sometimes I don't want to dive into all of this thing, but it has come to point that, you know, we'll have to jettison everything. These people that are doing this thing, I want to ask, you rightfully said that this woman called on one of the principal servant and said to him, if he can take over DOS. You said that, yes?
Yes.
Now.
Yes.
My question is, who is this woman? What is her background check? And when did this woman join IPOB? That is exactly what I want to ask you, so that people are listening, their friends are listening, and they want to know.
Okay. This woman is Lily of Ebu. And she joined IPOB, we call them a COVID IPOB. She joined IPOB 2020, during the COVID time. Even at this very moment, I still asking myself, if our leader is here, it doesn't matter how I respect him, but I'm going to ask him in a hard voice, harsh voice, where did you get this woman from? That's my question. They are not part of IPOB. They joined IPOB in COVID last year. And I never know who he is until the day I had a contact with her was the day she wanted to come on air. And then the broadcaster said, "Oh, what you want to say is not in line with what I say. Contact me." So she called me, what was it, like midnight. I said, "Huh, what I'm saying is nothing. You are bringing a division. What we need is a unity. You talk about how we can support what we are doing." He said, okay. And the family, the one, yeah. So she just called the phone. I never really had any conversation with her. I do not know who she is. But one thing I do know is they are the agent of her darkness.
All right, thank you very much. Thank you very, very much. As it is clear now that this woman joined IPOB during the time of COVID, and all of a sudden she came inside. What I'm wondering, how she gets so much information she is using it to destabilize us now.
What I want to ask was
how did she manage to get, yes, it's true that she will say that she is a what did they call her name, asset recovery manager, whatever.
How did she get into as I said, I never had her name. I don't know who she is. Until that very day, she contacted me. She only exists in America. And nobody knows her. And this is local, because IPOB has a very, very concrete structure. For you to break IPOB, there are so many pillars. And they have to travel so many countries. When the issue come up, I say, "Have you taken it to DRC? We have a court. Have you taken it there?" To the greatest of my surprise, I'm sorry to disappoint those who are backing her up. This matter has never met a conflict resolution committee, which we call the CRC.
Mazi, please repeat it again. You said she did not.
What I'm saying is, I told her, if you have any accusation, if you have any issue, if you have anything, we have a conflict resolution committee,
right,
which we call the CRC, which means our court, and it's our barristers. We are not meant to say barristers that are practicing in different countries. They are the ones in charge of things like that. So we have a very good institution. But in this case, they said nothing. Nothing has ever come there. I said, "Why don't you take it there? If you have a fact and it's a verifiable, take it there. Let them look into that. We have a court." So that goes to demonstrate that these people are the agent of destruction. And then in this sense, they are ladies and they are the agent. They are the daughters of Jezebel, because we have a part one in America. So they are the part two daughters of Jezebel. To destroy, distract, and then destabilize what we are doing. And with a false information to put people into problem. That is why they look at Mazi Chinasar. They have nothing to say about him. They have nothing to grab about him. And others, even Nnamdi, they made up something to look into. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Because they need to create. Because they are militia, they are paid, they need to deliver. So for it to be so the PDP, She was the campaign manager of Fanny Way.
That is and exactly what I want to ask you.
She has CPD APC since she was there. So she's under pressure to deliver. And then guess what? Poor Biafrans, they have to bear the brunt. Innocent people they are fighting, they have to bear the brunt. They've thrown up their different lies. And don't be surprised tomorrow when we come up, when we come up about me. Don't be surprised, just be watchful of that. Because they are specialized in blackmailing. But I'm not afraid. As I said, I've accomplished everything I came to decide to do. So if I go now, I think I've gone late.
All right, Mazi. You know, that is the reason why it is good once in a while to come up and have a conversation with your people, Biafrans. You know, like what you just lay on the table right now, I'm sure so many people haven't heard of that for a very, very long time, and now they are hearing it. Now, looking at what these people are doing, looking at how they are exposing information that are not supposed to be exposing, they know. Like they will say, we are following our leader. Here you are saying it, that so many people that our leader puts in so many strategic positions that even the DOS don't even know, only our leader. I'm not supposed to be saying this, but it is on the tight corner that we are. That is the reason why I'm saying it. That even the DOS don't even know it. But now this woman, She know everything now. She is bringing everything on air for people to see. She is not even hyping. That is to say, she has no mind. Or I will say, she is not working for IPOB. Rather, she is working for whatever she is working for.
It expands to so many areas. Our leader tried to carry women about because I do not blame him because I've worked with that man for since 2012. In 2013, I met him here for an hour plus. I said, "Is it this man? Is it this small man is making all this mess? So since then, I developed this bond with him. But before I joined, I went on what is called a self-journey to actually understand what I'm doing. Is this just cause? Or is it just... I'm saying this for everyone to go and take on this journey. If it is just a just cause or something else. So after that, I understand that it's worthy to spend your life on. And then that's when I fully in. So this man, he trusts people based on the, you don't say what come out of their mouth, but we have advanced. I'm not blaming, one hand I'm blaming our leader, another hand I'm blaming ourselves. Because they blame said IPOB. He said he needed 100 people. And that 100 people do not understand it. It's people of a pure heart. You don't have any grudges. You don't have anything against your fellow member. You love what we are doing. Your heart is like a child. That's why they use the word a virgin. So if your heart is not aware of this thing, then you are not. And you know in everything you have a devil. Then come in. You know, devil is not, you know, how we explain this. Devil, angel, they are all human. It's not somebody else you expect to come from a different planet. That's what we said in our day. You said, "Mother, between woman means your God, you can help me. I need it. Someone will come and become like help you out."
So that is exactly. So these people here, they do not, they can have a somebody else. But our leader had a good heart for everyone to follow. That's why he appointed them, and they give them that opportunity to excel. But then what happened? Along the line, they show their true color. And how did they show their true color? By exposing how they, who they are. Then you say, oh, why don't our leaders check them and see who they are in the spirit? You know, the moment you are in, the atmosphere you are in, or what is happening at that moment, brings up the reaction that happens at that particular time. So to solve this problem is, if there is anyone our leader have any in mind, others is bring that person to death. Just exactly when we did, for example, the controversy, the one they're talking about, Simon Eba, they said our leader gave his mother to come and broadcast on the radio, and we never give him that time to come and broadcast. And then our leader said, oh, we should give instruction, we should stop protesting on Monday. They said, no, we must continue. It was a compromise. But then they said, our leader said, Simon Eba to come and broadcast. You know, they are doubling deep. So you accept one, you do not accept the other. It doesn't make sense. So this is how you see people that are confused. Confused to the call. So if you are the adequate listener of Mazi and the Kanu listen. I am. I have graduated. I have every diploma. I was so clear. I talked to him many ways. I wish I don't have to. This evening, well, one is nominated. You do the background checking. Unfortunate for this lady, we didn't do any background checking. But that's the mistake we never make again. And that's why we didn't make that mistake on Simon Eba. Because we did the background checking. We asked him to come and sign a code of conduct on every other place, which he rejected. The rest is his. So had it been that we did it with any other person, come and sign this, and then we simply reject and then move away. That's fine. We are not holding anybody to that. But don't come back and hold it against us. Everybody must not be part of IPOB. Do not get me wrong. But one thing I have to say is I have to say the way it is. I don't need to massage anybody's ego. So these women, they are from the pit of hell. She has been expelled. She wants to kill many lives. But one thing is, if anybody died because of that, we hold them responsible, therefore hold them responsible. All right. If there is anything else you want to ask, feel free, please.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you very, very much for you allowing me to ask you this question. And I am asking this question, to be honest with you, as the people who want to ask this question. Now, if it is that this woman, Nelly Ofuebu, is asset recovery manager, I don't know whatever the name may be, you know, I am not somebody that do something with title now, and the way our leader structure things, that even the DOS cannot give the full details of things that our leader is doing, only him. You remember when our leader said the things we do, he knows, people that are close to him, no one, he is the only one that know that is the rest of them. Now, if it is that our leader puts this woman in this position, because I know me myself, I am in IPOB, I dare not move away from my line going to someone else's line. I must maintain my line. That is, I mean, when I mean my line, my duty, I must maintain my line of duty. If it is that our leader appointed this woman in so and so for she to carry out her duty on, why is it that if it is not plain? And second of them all was, this woman just came in, which I know as an IPUB member, that is not how we do it, things. She just come in during the COVID time when people are not even going out, and they give her this strategic position without even knowing. I hope you understand my question, Mazi.
Yes, I understand your question.
My question was, what was the things that our leader asked her to do? And why is it that he was not cross-checked properly before handing this position over to her, please?
Okay, yeah, I have a few answers to that, because I'm very, very glad, and I'm not a legal person, but I have been to court in the last 2 years, so I've seen how everything is worked, and I am not afraid of, even I'm excited of taking someone to court, actually. And I'm glad you raised this point up. Our leader appointed Emily, from what we understand, asset recovery. To write something and bring it up. If anything find unwanted, send it to CRC, and then they will bring it up. But because of her ego and other things, bought over by the zoo government, share money. I can't remember how much amount of money they give out. So what she's doing is they need to deliver urgently, because a number of election is coming up. They need to destabilize that to be as quick as possible. Everything is possible. So what they do is they pick up everything. Now, that is an interesting thing that you said, because I'm not a lawyer. Lawyer has to interpret that, translate that. Those people she mentioned on their name, they send money public to their account, they can sue her. Because the reason is it's a false information. If all those information is not correct, and she cannot prove any of those things. Because if somebody that has been expelled from IPOB, she wants to cause a collective damage to destroy IPOB. The good thing is America is a civilized world. You are allowed to sue someone. And all it takes is to get a light lawyer, good lawyer. Then they will spend all the money they have on this earth, and you claim all the damages. And at the end, the victory will be yours, because the way the court goes this, if you have the money, you are the one that is going to win. So what she's doing is she's making herself vulnerable, because there will be a series of a court suit. Because she's putting the life of people, innocent people, in danger by fabricating stories and all manners of things. Remember, what we're doing is things of the spirit. The evil one will never go unpunished. They will. Mark it. I swear with my life on this. We say it in adage, that only remains for us. Anybody that comes to temper us, we will see. So they are heading nowhere. What they need is to let them come out and express themselves, and then the proper lawsuit will follow, and the collective damage will follow. Then we can. Because it's good. Now, it's nothing like you can blackmail someone, anything of that. That's fine. But America is a civilized world, and the good thing is she's in the right, she is in the right place to do that. Anybody that wants to go madness, you can go madness as long as you like, but there is something that is sacred to us. That is Biafra Restoration. You do not joke with it to us. As I said earlier, our leader was not there. He just stepped out for a month plus or two months plus. People say, oh, give us somebody that speak with him. Bring this person here. Bring this person here. Bring. Are you kidding me? Are you all okay? Is your brain working perfectly okay? Do you actually know what is going on? I do not think you are normal. These people are piloting to bring down the structure of Mazi and the Kanu. They have formed everything, carrying it out. Just like it. Oh, Mazi, if you give me a second.
Mazi, please go ahead.
Just exactly what just came to mind. You know, when you speak, things come to you in the spirit. And then you see it coming before you, displaying before your eyes. Exactly, I will borrow the word from Efe, because I'm just saying, she said, no, these people from Women America, they said they want to come and fight the corruption in Ethiopia. I will ask her, how many of you remember the story of our leader talked about the Hausa people, how the Fulani conquered them? Do you understand? Do you remember that? The story of our leader?
Yes.
Okay. Now, this is where they borrowed the replica. Now, we say replica. We are the copyright of it. They approached these people by the world that are affiliated with IPOB. They provide money to them for data. And give them money and push information to go and talk to Nnennaya Anya and the crew. And they say they are coming to fight the corruption in Ethiopia. But in a real sense, they have a different agenda. Now, first thing they say, they want to come and fight the corruption in Ethiopia. I ask. Which corruption in Ethiopia? They cannot establish a single one of them. Not a single. If there is any single corruption, bring them out. What they came to do is, when you want to bring somebody down, your back is finite. And they become weak. Then you soak him out. So what they did is, they came and said, Nnamdi, she is the one that sold our leader. She bring all manners of her. So people will not have confidence sending money to Germany. Are you following me?
Are
you following me?
Yes, Mazi, I'm here. I'm following you. You're saying is in line.
Okay, good. So this is what this is their plan, I will tell you. I'm glad you asked this question. So their plan is, when our leader was arrested, because we built in the spirit and see all this here. Oh, they want to destabilize IPOB. We got the first class information. They brought out money to destabilize IPOB inside. Now, how do we do that? We share money. We buy people. We do everything. And then when that one is done, we bring out our allegation. Those that are so close, those that are close to our leader are the people that betrayed him. Who are they? They said, Nnamdi Anya. She's withholding the money that is so dear to us. For half a year, some money. They are playing with our intelligence, isn't it? Are you following me? They are playing with our intelligence. Months before our leader had a problem.
they started giving money to Eagle Prophet. That Eagle Prophet coming out on the air. Only God will save you unless you come out and confess. That's only how he's going to escape it. I'm not going to say any words, but anything that will save you is to come out and confess. They give him money, and then prophesizing this, he come out and tell them what is going to happen. And all these things he said, their plans, what a plan that is going to happen. Are you following me? So they make up this, give people's money, and the prophecy start talking about it. That someone is ordained by God. U.S. is compromised. That they are the people that betray our leader.
Unbelievable.
Oops.
Unbelievable.
I don't know how they come out of my mouth. Oops. I'm sorry.
Mazi, hold on. You know, like what you're saying right now is, yes, I understand that you don't want to say it, but you know, this Oops. One has been Oops. Like, are you with me?
Yes, I'm very bummed. I shouldn't say this.
Alright, you know, it's just like that. What you're about to say is just like headline. That is what everybody see. But there is this one that people don't see. Not many people know about it. That is one thing I want you to discuss with Biafrans, or possibly discuss it with me. But I want to say thank you very much for your time this morning. I never expected this, but that is what we'll get. Thank you once again.
No, but yeah. Thanks, sir, because at some point, because people go and listen to our leader said, if you do not hear from Radio Biafra, it's not truth. Then, but people start going somewhere else and say, oh, our leader trust, do they know how our leader said, oh, get someone about to come and broadcast on the Radio Biafra, then someone about
didn't want to sign the code of conduct
and our rule and regulation. They do not know that. But they just jump in and stay there. As I said, Radio Biafra is for our Biafrans, BPB, everything. You do not need to kiss anybody ass. You don't need to give anybody friends. If you need to broadcast, come over. We make the way for you to broadcast. That's how we are praying.
Simple. All right. So,
you don't need to kiss anybody ass. So, this is the fact, but they do not want to hear that. Because they are the people, they are the agent of destruction. So we need to identify them and call them by your name. Be bold enough. Be bold. If you lose what you have, believe you me, I will tell you now today, this evening, in this hour. If nothing, Nnamdi Kanu is, God forbid, we find it, we cannot see him tomorrow. Mazi Foma is gone. You will not see me ever and ever again. There is nobody that will come out and support said Biafra is mildly buzzing than they can do it. It's only man that ever stand the test and stand it. So it doesn't matter what you believe, what your emotion, whatever your emotion is pushing you to. Pushing you to all these people crap, all these people, it means nothing. If tomorrow our leader is not there, I'm gone. Understand that. There is nobody like him. He said this. And it's by the time we have it, I will quote him, his phrase, if you forgot it. He said, before we came, there was nobody like us. By the time we gone, there will be nobody like us. In Biafra, in Radio Biafra is where we worship. And Chukwukabiam is our God. Only that one, the heaven rejoiced. Why should we lie? Why should we betray him? Why should we fabricate lies? Because people that fabricate lies are coming from the pit of hell. If you want to serve your people, you say you are a disciple, do what Paul did. Peter, whatever, you abandon everything. Join and serve your people. If you have any other thing, ask
you. All right, I will. Before I say any other thing, I want to say that some Biafrans are thanking you for making our time, being on air, you know, going so deep, telling them what they need to know. They are very, very grateful to you this morning. So, in continuation in what I was saying before was, there are things that are happening that we don't even know. This one is happening on the ground. Now, I'm going to dress the table before I ask you this question. In time past, our leader said, whenever you see women come out in what we are doing, you know that Biafra is here. This is what our leader said. Yes. And they capitalize on what our leader is, what our leader said, and they are doing us harm.
I can address that. Yes.
Before you go ahead, hold on. Now, what I actually want to bring out, I just want to attach it to what you are about to say. What I actually want to bring out was, you know, this Women Forum. I don't know what it's called, but I know that it is Women Forum. I don't know if you heard about it. I'm not supposed to be saying
it,
but for the fact that we are trying to address our wound, we have to go to all parts and corner and bring all our problem and address it at the same time. You see this Women Forum, what is going on there? I'm not a woman, but what I have heard, what is going on there is something that we must look into. And I'm very, 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 very grateful to China Samori yesterday on how he addressed Biafran women. Please, with that, yeah, I want you to touch it.
I can comment on that.
Please go ahead.
Yeah, what I wanted to comment on that area is, you know, I will emphasize again about our leader. Our leader is that Messiah that comes in over 100 or 200, 500 years or 1,000 years. He is. Before anybody come to this earth, you do ask, who shall I send? Before you come to this earth, you know, within the chair, you are with their tents. And they say, who shall we send? And before you, we are sent. And when we went to services, and if you are in the spirit, devil is very, very active. And we'll be ready to take over or do whatever they want to do. Our leader said that that's correct. When women come out, their fight is here. Guess what? When we are planning something good, devil is the same time planning the same thing as well. They told us that heaven suffered violence, it was taken by force. Our struggle is going to take him by force, not by peace. What our leader is doing is referring us back. If you go back to Revelation, if you do not go back and read it, he will gather back all the bones from all four corners of the earth. His word is coming out of his mouth is like a sword. And that is so. That is the truth. The truth is what is going to destroy the zoo. If you go back in the Revelation, you read where he says that the beast, people were the beast, were killed. The beast were dead, but they were ruling in the name of the beast. If you remember that, they are ruling in the name of the beast.
That is true.
And people are afraid of the beast. What is going on today? Buhari has gone. They are ruling everyone in the name of the beast. And people are still afraid of the beast. So, you know, devil has a way. When I was really started, it started in a good faith. At some point, I don't blame him because we abandoned him.
It's not because our leader is a student of the history. I remember those back when he was about to come out, he said to me, "Where's your former? Does he put people worth dying for?" This was the question he asked me. 2016, 17, when he was about to come out, he said, "Does a Igbo man worth dying for?" So when you take deep into this meaning, I said to him, "Follow your gods. If your God said, we'll die, do it. But one thing I will tell you, Mazi Ofoma is by your side, not on your back. So everything I'm doing, I'm by the side of my leader. If he told me to stop, I will not question him. If he told me to move forward, I did not question him." Because that's when you phrase is a lawyer. I have a mother. We can make a mistake. When I phrase is a lawyer. I looked left and I looked right. There is nobody like him. His man of honor. Material things doesn't move him, and that is something I pick from him. Material things doesn't move him. It doesn't matter what anybody talks. It doesn't matter what blackmail anybody's blackmailing a fellow principal officer. Those people that were removed, they are just gossiping. They couldn't prove anything. They are blackmailing. They want to intimidate others. They want to put people's life in danger. So my answer this evening to you, Mazi Below, is if anything happened to any of those people, those that have put that video, Nini and Co, we hold them responsible. Their family, anywhere they come from, we hold them responsible. Biafra, we hold them responsible. They are the people that are holding us from living, getting to our promised land. We should all rise. Anybody that are giving money for that time, it doesn't matter who that person is, speak up. Go after them. Tell them who it is. They cannot do you nothing. I swear, before heaven and earth, they will fall before your feet. So rise up and speak up the way it is. Thank you, Master Bino. If there is anything else, go ahead.
Thank you very much. Thank you very, very much. What I pick out from this last question that you answer was Onye Feze is a Ruya. That is to say, or that means loyalty. Loyalty, Biafrans, loyalty. And because today is Shabbat, I will want you to go to the book of Corinthians chapter 4. Read it. Corinthians chapter 4, maybe from 2, or from the beginning, maybe. Read it, then you will understand exactly what our brother say. Onye Feze is a real. Mazi Ofoma, I want to say thank you very, very much for allowing yourself to come to this program and allowing me, just me, you know, just I asking you question and you're answering, because but I want to say thank you very, very, very much for me. Biafrans, they are grateful.
If there is any more question, feel free to ask. We are happy to answer it. And I have been the servant and royal servant of our leader for the last 9 years.
All right.
So there is nothing anybody will tell me about him. The character, anything, I will not tell. That man is the most respected, patient, calm warrior that you can ever think of to meet on your head, on your life, if I may say.
Right. Now, I will say this. Now, with what they are doing, and it is affecting IPUB family members, my question is, those coordinators that has fallen, or that coordinators that has, you know, like, there are so many, like, we listened to our DOS, head of DOS yesterday, and with what he said, we understand that this is actually happening. So my question is, the question that I'm going to ask is, what is your message to those Biafrans under those coordinators that has fall behind, those that are fall by the wayside? What is your message for them? Like people, like I would say, not by my power, okay, but by the grace of God. So what is your message for them, please?
Yeah, what I have to say is, many we are called, but few we are choosing. It's written in the scripture. Not those that start, we end it. But blessed those that started and end it. So if you are one of those that started, pray to be one of the people that will end it. Mazi, my father, was one of the people that started, but it's nowhere to be seen today. So that is it. Many we are called, few we are choosing. My prayer every day is, let me be among those that end it, because it's an honor. And a privilege, out of millions and millions of people, to be among the people to serve our people, is an honor. If you do not understand that, I will explain what it means. It means that you humble yourself before your people. It means that you care about others before your people. It means that you want better life for your people before others. It means that you don't worry your life for anything. Your life means nothing. You want to help those that cannot help themselves before you. It's a great honor. And without any shadow of doubt, I will be proud and over again to identify myself with such people. For the last 15 years or so, I've been giving to a lot of charities. I don't want to mention their names. The question is, why wouldn't I give to mine? I'm that so heartless. They put something on this for us to identify who we are, what we want to achieve, to help our kind, to uplift them. That is why it's important for us to know who we are, know who we are related with, know who we interact with. Because with these people, they have a lot of bad spirit in them. As I said, they are the agent of darkness. If you want to drill down, they are the daughters of Jezebel, part two. They will uphold you, they will stop you from reaching your destination. They will do all manners of things to convince you, bring all manners of lies and falsified information to deceive people. But there is one thing they do not have power for those people to verify it or ask. What I expect those people to do is to ask questions. Go to their coordinators. Go to the people that speak to them. Kindly, politely, throw this question to them. And they will get an honest question. There is one thing I want us to understand. These people are the enemy of our people. They are our enemy. You do not need to preach peace and build them. They are the people to stop you from your destination. You do not understand it. They are the people to hold you back. They will come up with all manners of accusation, sweet words, learn it, to deceive you. When they started, we asked providers evidence. Till this very moment, I swear by the name of Chukwok Gadiama, there is no evidence that you take to the court of law that the judge we accept or the clerk we accept to file a court case. What does that tell you? It tells you that these people, they came for destruction. They are the agents of darkness. They are the people we should be watchful of. We should be watchful of people they are working with. We should stop them at all costs. We make sure they do not progress forward. We make sure we show them anywhere we see them. We make sure we pursue them. We never allow them to rest. Anybody that is sharing anything from them, they are part of them. They are the part of the agents of darkness. They are the people that do not want Jeffrey to come. That's how you define them.
All right, Mazi.
This is what I have to say about the video.
Thank you very much, Mazi. I also, you know, while you were saying something, I remember something that I had on her clip. You know, the reason why I want to ask this thing was I also had it from someone else. And so I want to bring it to you this morning. Is it, or I will say, please explain it to us that they say that each time you want to lay a complaint, they will say to you there is a channel for you to lay your complaint. They will say to you that you have a channel to lay your complaint, but in the real sense of it, when you take your complaint to them, they will put it under the carpet. They will be doing this and this and that to delay so that no one will hear your complaint. This is the reason why they are going out wide the way they are going out wide. So I would want you to address this and tell us why that is false.
I will refer back to the Bible. None of Moses, the law and all this, that person said there is so many work. We need to appoint people. I may not say it correctly because it's a long time that I read outside of the Bible. They appoint people, judges and others, to look into the matter of the people. And that is what IPP did. There are so many cases. Just like when you file a case at the court, you wait for your death. At least you wait up to 4 months, if I'm not mistaken, depending on the country you are in and depending on the type of corporate. The same thing. So the question is to those people, they thought that their case is a high priority. You should address them. So if there is a high priority, there is a room to fast track high priority. Because in every judiciary, you have if there is a high priority, there is a specialty you have to fill in and others to see. No, it's a high priority. And then the clerk and others, he has to examine it and then say, yes, this merited the high priority, then proceed it forward to be on the front of the queue. But none of these things were done by these people. As I said, they never even gone to CRC to report any matter. If these people are in love of what the structure must in and the kind of defense, they should at least obey his instruction or his structure he put in place by the taking the matter to the right places. Now, if those places didn't take action, I would be one of the people that will support them. Yes, they bring it here, they didn't do nothing. I swear I'll be one of the people speaking it here by this time, this hour on this radio, saying yes, they bring this matter, they did not look into it, they are compromised, but the answer is they did not bring anything closer to anything. They did not even file nothing. They do not have nothing to file against. All they wanted to do is to destabilize our account in Germany, removing Nnamdi from the scene, destabilize IPOB, stop ESN, collect the big check from the zoo government, and then go and relax and enjoy it. And then those of you that are yapping on the Facebook that give a $50 naira that charge a card, organize people, you'll be talking rubbish from thy kingdom come, you'll be stupid forever and ever, and I wouldn't even talk to many of you forever and ever because you have no brain. That is what is going on. They have no case to report. They are on their mission.
and their mission have time to, they need to deliver ASP. So anything that is coming from them, know that it's coming from the pit of hell. The question, the simple question you ask is, provide us the evidence of the first one you report before we even consider looking into your second one. Then we get frustrated, then we start attacking them. That is how you know who they are. For those that are ignorant, that are following them, this is the time to do a revise back. Because when they bribe you with the money, you cannot speak. Like our leader said, Ibulungwela, you can't speak. You already swallow. You can't speak. You can't make it. You cannot. Because you already bought over. The next thing, they start blackmailing you. So the only thing you do is to mute, keep quiet. Isn't it a shame? You say you're in this struggle. You are fighting for Biafra restoration. Many of your friends has died. You are since 20, whatever that cannot come, no? Because of material things. You sold yourself. You sold your soul for peanuts. May I ask this evening, sir, if indeed I chukwok Kajama, as he has taken care of the Fulanis and the Fulani Caliphate that are killing all those that said over their dead body, if we need to do any sacrifice to make sure we remove that from our own people, so he start taking our own people that are killing us, give us the sign, so we do that. It's the time you start killing any house. So, well, okay, no, no, well, okay, no, 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 no. If there is none, then we have peace. That's all I have to say, Mazi.
Yeah. Mazi, thank you very much. Thank you very, very much. I'm grateful for having you on the show this morning. And this is where we will draw the curtain for this program this morning here, right here. And once again, it is a very big thank you to me. A very big thank you from me to you, and Biafrans are also saying likewise. I will say, please give us your parting shot, like we said earlier, by praying for the nation of Israel, because we are going into prayers right now. Thank you very much, Mazi. Please.
Thank you, Mazi. You know, Israel is always my second home. Throughout my teenager age, I spent it in Israel, and Israel always have a place in my heart, and I will never stand in the mix of people where they will condemn Israel, because they were so kind to me. I still have a lot of family friends, I'm still communicating to them, and I call it a home, and I will have a in a short distance time, I will have a home there where we have a place. If I need to come on holiday, I will come and relax and enjoy myself. And we call upon the name of Chukwoku Kadiama to continue to guide us, protect Israel, protect the Biafra land. Israel preserve our history for us to be have a place to make a reference to there. Without Israel, we wouldn't have been today, we would have been people like nothing. They preserve our history for us to have a look, to remember who we are, to return back to our Creator. Now, Chukwoku Kadiama, blessed be to them. I will ask you to continue to bless your children. Those that are trying to distract us, those that are trying to destroy what you are doing, those that are trying to destabilize what your children, Mazi, your servant, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is doing. He's in the enemy camp. You are aware of that. You approve that to take place. We know that. You said you allowed that to happen. For everything you plan to come to fruition. The same time, you allow the enemies of the Jezebel part to take place. So that your word will come to fulfill. Let not any of us be part of those that we go against your will. Rather, we should seek for your mercy.
We should seek for your face for the restoration of your kingdom. We will worship you in truth and in honesty. That night, where the whole world will come and bow before you and say, indeed, there is God like you. Not what we know today, because it's not what our ancient, our people ancient worship. Our forefather worship you. We know indeed how great you are. But pardon us. Everything is written down. But because we misunderstood it, we do not understand nothing from your word. But today, we know better. Today, we understand everything that comes from your mouth. And we ask you, we have one thing they do not have, which is you. Our leader said the Biafra will be the last miracle on earth. And we believe in that. Considering what is happening to us today, we mocked the Israelites. They wandered in the wilderness for 40 years. They couldn't. Now look at your children. We have been fighting for Biafra for something years. Nobody is holding us. We are the ones that are sabotaging ourselves. Like the women in America sabotaging ourselves. Nobody. History is repeating itself. But have mercy. We are not part of it. We have seen, we have asked for comment. The feast of Tabernacle is still going on. We remember your covenant you made with your servant, God. On that we stand. We are not worthy because we disobey your commandment, your covenant you have with us. But for the sake of your servant Isaac, for the sake of your servant Mazi and the Kanu, because he said, who shall I send? He said, my father, to come and redeem my, redeem your people. Have mercy. May those that come to destabilize us, may those who come to kill us, destroy them.
You see?
Take them away.
You see?
Before our own eyes. May they never live to see tomorrow. May their generation be white.
You see?
May everything about them become a history.
You see?
May nobody remember anything about them.
You see?
We did nothing wrong to these people. All we are campaigning for is the restoration of your kingdom on this earth. Heavenly Father, unless if there is nothing be like you, then they will continue to prevail. But if there is, then your will start to happen. It's not tomorrow. It's not next tomorrow. If you say you are God of, if you say you are God of now, like the ancient call upon you now, he start answering the now. We said, may it start to happen now. And now we start to speak and call upon your name. That shall it be. And that's where it's going to happen. We ask in your precious name, Kiko Kukadiyama. You
see?
You see?
You see?
You see?
You see? Thank you very much, Mazi. Thank you very much. I'm very grateful to have you on the show. Thank you very, very much. And see you again next week. Call me. I'm happy to come back and talk.